What's good, YouTube? Welcome back to the Brown Gen. In this video, we're going to talk about Manta Pacific, their new paradigm campaign just wrapped up, and you're probably wondering what your next steps are. So let's get right into it, but just remember, nothing I say in this video is financial advice. And after watching the video, if you still need coaching, support, guidance, etc., we've got a great community of individuals in the Web3 Secret Society. If you want to join, check out the YouTube memberships right below the video. Now, as a reminder, everything I show here today will be linked in the description below, so don't worry about squinting to find those URLs. Now, something I do want to mention, and we've been talking about it a bit, there have been some people commenting on my previous videos about Manta. I know a lot of people have been asking, hey, is it too late to deposit? And for the last few weeks, I've been telling people pretty much yes. Unless you're depositing a significant amount, there was no point to deposit, because unless you got a full box, what exactly is the point? And about a few days ago, we started noticing a timer ticking down on the New Paradigm Manta website. I think the first time I saw it, it had like 4 days and 18 hours left, and it ticked down all the way to yesterday night, and at which point it got replaced with the following message: Phase one has ended on January 16th, 2024. You can still open any boxes you currently have and combine them, but you can't get any new boxes or box pieces. Stay tuned for the next phase of New Paradigm. Now, obviously, the way they communicated this was not optimal. I'm pretty sure I did not see a single announcement, and they used to talk about how deposits would end in January at some point, and then they told us the date, but it was sort of different, sort of looking at deposits versus box generation. And I know a lot of people who missed out on a bunch of boxes because of this. In fact, if I got a shot, like, I'm recording this at like Tuesday at midnight, but let me tell you something. I was getting two boxes in like 12 hours from now. Sucks, but hey, you know, things could be worse. So hey, so be it. Everyone's got to deal with it. You know, this is a great opportunity either way, and I made a ton of money doing so. One thing that you would be interested to know is your, at least for me, it seems like I'm unable to deposit any more into New Paradigm. So, you know, people are probably wondering, why would you want to deposit into New Paradigm? Because, like, you're not getting any more boxes. Well, here is the other opportunity. If you can't deposit and you can't get any more stone token, all of a sudden, if people want to deposit more in those partners like Layerbank and Shoebill, there is no longer such a great opportunity to do that. And that got me thinking, would that mean that we would see less of a premium to turn ETH into stone? And in fact, could we take our Ethereum off the platform at a minimal cost? So if you actually take a look at Aperture Swap, and let's go through this here and swap it to Manta. We'll swap it to Manta Pacific. Yeah, we'll hit the switch button and follow through on MetaMask. We'll take one Ether and one stone and see sort of what this will look like. So I'm just gonna type this in here. And if you remove one stone from your contract, you only pay 0.05 Ethereum. So it's only 5%. This is a much better deal than it was a couple of days ago. And in fact, let's see what it looks like if you do it for less. So 0.4, you pay like, yeah, it's about a 5% swing, 4 to 5% swing. So it's gotten better. And that is definitely because people are probably saying, hey, now might be an opportunity even still to deposit and get the stone token just to get those extra rewards. Now, if we're taking a look at sort of the approach going forward, I don't think they've given some clarity yet on how the airdrop will work. My guess, based on what I've seen from, you know, what they're doing for the other, I think it's Into the Blue campaign and other such campaigns from other protocols, they're typically going to wait to like basically allow you to redeem, most likely, like an NFT for tokens of Manta. And that's because, like, if you did a snapshot of the Manta NFTs and then people sort of trade them like you can on Element, all of a sudden it's sort of bad for those who get the NFT after the fact and then are like, wait, I can't do anything with it because the screenshot has been done. And you know, you'd see a lot of people fall for that. So I think they're going to avoid that and probably just have a sort of, you swap that NFT for X amount of tokens, and that will all be determined by the time they decide the airdrop claiming date. One thing I do want to highlight is since the campaign has ended, the prices of all of these NFTs have gone up. If you remember last week when I talked about buying a lead code, you could buy it for 0.31. I have now sold mine since it appreciated, and it's not a, you know, if you want to get the swing that way, it's not bad. You can also sort of sell or swing some of the other NFTs. You can probably still trade them. Now, one of the things I will mention is it is very relevant to you to follow Element and make sure that you have the Element NFT webpage open to this, especially when the claiming comes out. Because if you do some quick math, you'll be able to figure out if it's actually worth buying the NFT off the marketplace and sort of getting the tokens for Manta, selling them right away and rinsing and repeating, or not. So there may be another arbitrage opportunity there. One thing I do want to highlight too is Manta this morning, or I guess yesterday morning, released sort of more of their native utility and the governance token, which is like, you know, $Manta. And they have a Medium article, which I will link in the description below. You don't really have to go through too much of it because a lot of this is very technical. And I know most of you are here to farm airdrops. But what you should know is the overview of Manta. The total supply is 1 billion tokens, a 2% yearly minting rate starting from that token genesis. So we'll see, like, you know, after the first year, there'll be 1 billion and 20 million tokens. And the whole idea of Manta is it's just governance and you can stake it to sort of improve the security of Manta Atlantic. You know, network fees, Manta Atlantic uses Manta to pay transaction fees, and it can be used as collateral in the ecosystem. So probably what most of you care about is what's the utility of Manta, right? So there's Manta Pacific, and basically there's value accrual for token holders. They benefit from the productive redeployment of sequencer revenue and gas savings. And you know, there's some other stuff over here. So I'm not going to go through all this, but it's very interesting. They have an airdrop portion below. It is very important to see the token allocation. So this is always very important. You want to know who's getting tokens at a lower price than you, such as the private investors, such as the team, you know, institution investors, strategic investors, private investors, and public investors. And then you sort of have all of everything else that's going on here. So I'm going to scroll down a little bit here. You know, like I said, the link will be in the description. You can see here the cliff of the token release schedule. So it's important to see if you are thinking of holding Manta token after the fact, where the points of dilution will be. Now, over here, you can see here one of the airdrops is 5.6%. This is the Into the Blue 50 million tokens. It unlocks during the Genesis event. 6 million unlocks during TGE, and then it's sort of distributed to users participating in the Binance Parachain auction. Then there's a new paradigm campaign, which we've been talking about, airdrop number 2. This is where like 6.5% will be allocated to new paradigm participants. 3% is total supply, is base reward. 2% is special rewards, and 1.5% is the ecosystem incentives. That sort of corresponds to sort of all of that we've been discussing, right? Like, we've talked about these allocations in the past. And any unclaimed rewards after the claim period will be distributed back into the ecosystem funds. So one of the things I'll tell you is make sure you stay on top of this. You don't want to sit there with the NFTs after the fact and go, wait a second, we were supposed to redeem these. Those NFTs are nice, but hey, you know, I like cash even better. Make sure you Stay on top of that. If you want to have that, make sure you subscribe to the channel, because I will be making a large video. I'll be making a ton of noise when it's available. So even if you're out there enjoying life, trust me, if you hit the bell icon and subscribe, you will know when it's available. So I will sort of leave this document there for now. One more thing I will mention is on Gate.io, if you check out most coin listing websites, Manta is supposed to launch on January 18th. You see here, there's a ticker for 2 days and 4 hours. In fact, I believe on January 18th, those who are part of the Into the Blue campaign, their airdrop, their claiming goes live right then. And I think right after that, at some point, we'll follow a new paradigm. On top of that, if you are with those partners, if you're with Layer Bank Finance, or if you're with Shoebill, more stuff coming. So there's a ton of support that's been given. So Layer Bank is committing a 250K Lab M tokens to Manta token holders. And concurrently, Shoebill is offering 500,000 SBL, which is their governance token, for an airdrop to Manta holders. And I think it's sort of really cool that, you know, this is something that these partners are doing. And remember, if you look at Layer Bank, which I think there's a ton of potential there, if you go into their ecosystem and see everything else, there's going to be a ton of rewards coming out for Manta. And this still does not incorporate what happens to people who are just staking Celestia with validators. We know Celestia is like one of the best tokens coming out of 2023. I'm excited for it in 2024. You know, a lot of influencers are saying it'll hit triple digits. I mean, I'd be happy if it broke $50. I think there's going to be a lot more people staking Celestia TIA token, you know, whether it's for Milky TIA on Osmosis, you know, DMX Exchange, or a Quasar Finance. The reality is there's a ton of use case and a lot of people want that exposure. And when that happens, people don't end up selling Celestia, even if they expect a correction. So tons of things to look forward to. You know, I think I'm very excited about Manta. If there's one thing I would change, it's really around how they communicated this. I found out about the close really from the moderators and then sort of this timer clicking down. The one thing I want to leave you with is, before we forget anything else, we're doing a lot of farming of airdrops, especially if you follow a lot of people on Twitter. There's a ton of Twitter threads, and scammers are getting better at separating people from their money. Take a look at what happened to Crypto Grady. He got scammed and lost a good $15,000 tonight because he was following a project that's legitimate and, you know, has some good things going. He's doing some steps thinking that he was farming an airdrop, and he had accidentally fallen victim to clicking to a phishing link posted by somebody who is very similar in account to the main account. And because of it, he lost $50,000. Kind of, you know, obviously you hate to see it happen. Grady's a good guy. But I always sort of tell you guys, no matter how sort of like careful you are, everyone slips up. You can never be perfect. And that's why I always tell people, do whatever you can to put more blockades in the way to prevent scammers from getting your money. And remember, I am not sponsored in any way by this company, but the sort of tool that I found to be the most helpful is WalletGuard. In fact, there was another individual who had used WalletGuard. You know, let me go find this. I posted it on Twitter earlier because I saw this, and this is somebody else I talked to a ton. His name is Solana Income. You know, follow him on Twitter. 4 days ago, he posted that he almost got caught by a wallet trainer chasing airdrops, and he said the same thing. They're getting sneakily good at adding shady links to legitimate threads. Thank you, WalletGuard, for catching this. He DM'd me, told me the pop-up came. He had no idea. And because of it, he saved his money. You know how happy that makes me sound, or makes me feel, because those scammers didn't get away with it and then he got to keep his money? And like, yeah, he thanked me for introducing WalletGuard, but you know what? I'm just happy that people are starting to protect themselves. Please, you don't have to get WalletGuard. Just look for WalletGuard or any service like this that will help put another barrier in the way, because I really don't want to see you guys get hurt. Anyways, that's pretty much it for this video. If you like the video, please hit the like button, share the video with a friend, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you need extra support, we got you. We got the white glove service here in the private group, Web3 Secret Society. Tons of alpha dropping. Whenever there's an update on anything, I post it there first. And then if I can get on YouTube and post a video and it's big enough, maybe I'll do a video. But they hear about everything, charts, resources, who to stake with, everything else. And if you have any questions, they got their own private rooms to ask that stuff. It's pretty cool. If you're interested, we got the YouTube membership below. I want to thank you all for watching, however, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.